Hello and welcome to the draw of the 2023 FISU University World Cup football that will take place from 21st to 31st October in Xinjiang, China. We will start with the women's draw of this tournament, and together with me, my name is Alejandro Guerra. I have my colleagues Paolo Sivieri.
Hello.
And Chloe Dragani.
Hi.
From the FISU World Cups and Championships department. So, as I said, we will start with the women's draw, and we will start by introducing the different teams participating in this competition. So, as host team representing China, we have the Beijing Normal University. Representing Oceania from Australia, the University of Sydney. From Americas, representing Brazil, Paulista University. From Europe, from France, the University of Bordeaux. Representing Africa, from Guinea, the University of Kindia. From Thailand, representing Asia, the College of Asian Scholars. And the two wildcards of the competition, the Goethe University of Frankfurt from Germany, and the Paulo Tichima Women Pedagogical University from Ukraine. These teams will be placed in two groups, Group A and Group B. Before proceeding to that, I'd like to explain the basic rules of the draw. Basically, the host team will be placed automatically in position A1 as per the FISU technical regulations for the competition. Then we need to consider that there are some continents that have more than teams representing them in the tournament, so only one team from each continent can be placed in one group. The only exception to this rule is Europe, because there are three European teams, so we can have a maximum of two of them. The order of the draw will be following positions A1, B1, A2, B2, and so on. So this order can be altered, modified, in case we need to respect the rules before mentioned. And now, while I explain the pools in which the teams will be placed, my colleagues Paolo and Chloe will be placing the five first teams in the pools. But before that, we will place the Beijing Normal University as host team in position A1. They won't be part of any pool. And then they will be putting in the respective bowls the five winners of the continental qualifying tournaments that, as we mentioned before, are the University of Sydney from Australia, the Paulista University from Brazil, the University of Bordeaux from France, the University of Kindia from Guinea, and the College of Asian Scholars from Thailand. These teams have been placed in this pool one because they have all been qualified as winners of the continental tournaments, so they are all ranked equally. And now Chloe will proceed to extract the first ball. So please, Chloe, throw the balls and take the first one out. That, as explained before, will be placed in position B1.
University of Bordeaux.
So the University of Bordeaux, it's in position B1 for the tournament. Now Chloe will take the second ball that will be allocated to position A2.
University of Kindia.
The University of Kindia from Guinea will be in position A2 in the tournament. Chloe will take now the team number 3 that will be allocated in Group B, position 2.
College of Asian Scholars.
The College of Asian Scholars from Thailand is representing Asia, and that's perfect because that means that we avoid the conflict set by the rule that no more than one team from one continent can be in the same group, except for the European exception. So now we can continue normally with the draw. Please, Chloe,
The University of Sydney.
The University of Sydney will be placed Group A, position 3. And that means that our last team in position B3 will be
Paula University.
The Paulista University from Brazil. Now, to continue with the draw, my colleagues once again will introduce the two remaining teams, both Europeans, the Goethe University from Frankfurt, Germany, and the Paulochina Humanist State Pedagogical University from Ukraine in the balls. And this will be the pool number 2 in this women's competition draw. And now Chloe will once again draw the two teams to decide their respective positions as A4 and B4. So the first one, it's
Goethe University of Frankfurt
that goes to position A4. And the last team in this draw,
Pavlochina Human State Pedagogical University.
The Ukrainian team will go in position B4. That means that the group B will have the two European teams, and that the draw is now completed with the 8 teams. Hello and welcome to the men's draw of the 2023 FISU University World Cup Football that will take place in Xinjiang, China from the 21st to 31st October this year. My name is Alejandro Guerra, and together with my colleagues Paolo Sivieri.
Hello.
And Chloe Dragani.
Hello.
From the FISU Championships and World Cups Department, we will be conducting this draw. To start, we would like to introduce the 12 teams competing in the men's tournament. We will have, as previous winner, the University of the Republic from Uruguay. As host team from China, the Hohai University. Representing America from Brazil, Paulista University. From Africa, coming from Kenya, the Kenyatta University. Coming from Korea, representing Asia, the Myeonggi University. From Oceania, representing New Zealand, the University of Auckland. From Romania, representing Europe, the West University of Timișoara. From Argentina, the University of La Matanza. From Australia, the Western Sydney University. From Ukraine, the State University of Trade and Economics. From Croatia, the University of Split. And from Spain, the Ramon Llull University. Now that you know the 12 participating teams, it's time to start explaining the basic rules we will follow in this draw. So following the FISU technical regulations, we cannot have more than one team for each of the 4 groups in which we will place three teams. So we will follow the natural order of extraction of the balls by alphabetical order to place the teams, but might be the case that we need to alter, to modify the order of the draw based on that rule, to avoid that we have more than one team of each continent in each respective group. The other group that needs to be followed is that the host team is placed automatically in the position 1 in the group A. So now I will start explaining the pools, but basically Hohai University from China doesn't need to be included in any of the pools created for the draw because they are automatically allocated in group A, position 1. Then the other team that now we have to draw a position is the University of the Republic from Uruguay, as previous winner, is not allocated to any other pool. They are ranked as the second top team in this tournament. So what we will be doing is deciding by draw in which of the other three remaining groups, B, C or D, they will be placed. So Chloe, please, Chloe will be introducing balls with the groups B, C, and D in this pool. And the University of the Republic will be placed in whichever group position one Chloe extracts. Yeah, please draw it a bit. So the University of the Republic will go to group C position one, as explained before. And now to continue with the draw, we'll have the pool number one, which is composed by the five teams that have qualified as winners of their respective continental qualifying tournaments organized in 2022. So we have the Paulista University coming from Brazil, winner of the EUSA, of the FISU America Games. We have the Kenyatta University from Kenya, winner of the FASU Games. Then we have the Myeonggi University, and they were placed in third position in the last FISU World Cup in 2019, and they get this spot given that the AUSF couldn't organize a qualifying tournament. The University of Auckland was the winner of the qualifying tournament organized by FISU Oceania. And last, the winner of the EUSA Games is the West University of Timișoara from Romania. So now that we have the five balls in the pool, Paulo, please, he will be taking the balls. And before drawing this pool, we need to consider one possible conflict. In the group A, we have already an Asian team, and in the group C, we have already an American team. So we need to consider
Kenyatta University, Kenya.
So the Kenyatta University will go to the first free spot, which is group B, position one. Now we will continue with the draw. And the next position, next team will go to group D, position one.
Myeonggi University, Korea.
So the Korean team will be in group D, position one, and that already makes the rest of the draw a bit easier, because we have now the two Asian teams in two different groups. So that's already something good.
Western University of Timișoara, Romania.
So the Romanian team will go in group A, position two. We still have two more balls to be extracted from pool one.
Paulista University, Brazil.
So the Brazilian team from Paulista University will be placed in group B, position two. That's also good, because in that way we avoid conflict in the group C.
University of Auckland, New Zealand.
And the last team missing in the pool one was the University of Auckland from New Zealand, and they will be placed in group C, position two. Now, we will continue with the draw of the pool two, which is composed by the three teams that got their spot based on the home method, which is basically a system to reward those continental qualifying tournaments that got better FISU members representation in them. So these three teams are the University of La Matanza from Argentina, the Western Sydney University from Australia, and the State University of Trade and Economics from Ukraine. Now, Chloe and Paulo are placing them in the respective balls, and Paulo will be drawing the first ball. We have to avoid here some possible conflicts, especially in group B. We cannot have two American teams, so we will see.
State University of Trade and Economics, Ukraine.
So the Ukrainian team goes to group D, position two.
University of La Matanza, Argentina.
So the Argentinian team goes to Group A, position 3, and that's good because that way we avoid the conflict of American teams that were already placed in Group B and C.
Western Sydney University.
Because
Australia.
Of the composition in the pool 3, which is composed by two European teams, we will have to place the Western Sydney University in the only group that has already an European team and that is not in conflict with the other two remaining teams. So Western Sydney University will be placed in Group D, position 3. And now we will go to the draw of the two remaining teams that compose the pool number 3. Those are two European teams, the University of Split from Croatia and the Ramon Llull University from Barcelona, Spain. I will be placing them. And following the natural order, the first team will go in position B4. B3, sorry.
University of Split, Croatia.
So the University of Split goes in Group B. And that means that
Ramon Llull University, Spain.
The Spanish team, the Ramon Llull University, is in Group C, position 3. So with that, we conclude the draw ceremony for the men's tournament. We wish the best of the luck to all the teams, and we hope to see you very soon in Xinjiang on around 20 or 19 of October when all the teams will arrive, and with the competition starting on the 21st of October. See you there. Bye-bye.